you can register to vote at the blue tent with the McCain sign.
Please. Scores of new voters are expected to cast ballots in this year's presidential election. Some will be new U.S. citizens voting for the first time. At naturalization ceremonies like this one, voter registration workers have tried to sign up newly eligible citizens. Republican and Democratic Party workers are seeking every way to expand their party roles ahead of what is expected to be a tight presidential election. In Miami, the pace of voter registration is up over past years. Carlos Pereira of the Immigrant Orientation Center says the election is drawing keen interest from Hispanic voters.
Voter registration is the key issue of the moment for Hispanics. There is a certain urgency, not just this election, but for years, to resolve key issues like immigration reform and to improve the economy.
Voter turnout in this year's presidential primary jumped over previous primary election periods. The numbers doubled in Florida, as well as Iowa, Virginia, Arizona, and other key states over 2004. Some experts say the surge is likely to continue in the November general election. Kevin Wagner, a political scientist at Florida Atlantic University, says election officials should be preparing for big turnout. He says the added numbers may pose challenges for states that allow early voting and on election day.
So we're likely to get some new voters here. Do they vote early? Do they know how to vote early? That might actually lead to issues with the voting machines themselves, because you're going to have a good number of voters that probably are not familiar with any of the technologies.
Election officials in Florida already are on the lookout for potential trouble caused by new voting technology. Florida and several other states are replacing touchscreen computer machines with paper ballots. The ballots are read by an optical scanner, which keeps the paper forms in case of a recount. Dennis Conklin is educating voters in Broward County, Florida, about the change.
We now have to, across the entire state of Florida, vote on paper. Each county gets to determine how they want to do that, but they must vote on paper.
Concern about the security of touchscreens led Florida lawmakers to replace the machines, which were only introduced in 2004. Critics said computer hackers could alter votes in the machines. Many touchscreens had no paper trail of the votes cast, raising additional fears of potential tampering. FAU's Kevin Wagner says officials are hoping the new optical scan machines will diminish those fears.
But does that mean that we won't have errors? Will people bumble the wrong places? Will they not understand the bumbling? Sure, and it's going to happen.
Election officials are striving to educate voters about proper ways to mark or bubble their ballots to ensure that all votes are counted. The first test of the optical scan technology comes in August, when Florida votes on local posts. Brian Wagner, VOA News.